Hello students, I am your English mentor and today I have come to you with one more interesting topic and it's called Wonderland. What is a Wonderland? Wonderland is a place where everything is wonderful. Everything is so unusual and lovely. Let's read a story on this Wonderland. So, do you know what is a Wonderland? A land where everything is wonderful and unusual or uncommon. It's an imaginary place. It's a place that is not present on the planet Earth, but it's just a place that we can imagine and think out of our own mind. So, let's begin. Taha, Susan, Asmi and Anil all were friends. There were four friends who Taha, Susan, Asmi and Anil. So, near their homes, there was an old factory land, old building and a lot of open space. So, where they used to live, there was an old factory land, building and lots of open space. So, it was next to the woods. It was next to the woods means it was next to the jungle. So, one day they were playing hide and seek. Hide and seek is a game in which the one person covers its eyes and all of them run and hide at some place. And then this person opens their eyes and looks for them. So this game is called hide and seek. And it was Taha's turn. Susan, Asmi and Anil, they went to hide. So she was the one who was supposed to find all three of them. One, two, three. They were all her friends and it was her turn to call them out for. Right after that, they decided to hide together. So, all three of them hid together. Taha counted up to 10 and then she started seeking them. So, Taha closed her eyes and counted up to 12. Meanwhile, all three of them decided to hide together. And then Taha started looking for all of them. So, she was calling their names while seeking them. So, she was calling out their names one after another while looking for them. She looked behind the broken doors and windows, but of no use. So, since the area was very big, she was looking behind the windows and also the broken doors, but all of no use. Because she was not able to find any of them. So, all three were hiding at the base of a very large chimney. All the three friends, where were they hiding together? They were hiding together on the base of the very big chimney. It was very dark there. They could see Taha, but to her, they were not visible. So, all three of them could easily see Taha. But Taha was not able to see them. So, Taha came closer to the place. All three got more backward. All of a sudden, Anil, who was at the last, felt something opening from the back. Now, when all three of them were hiding together and Taha was coming towards them, they just went a little backward. They moved a back. And when they moved a back, then Anil, who was towards the end, found that there was a slight opening right there. So, he fell back, followed by Asmi, but Anil kept his hand on Susan's shoulder, which made her also fall back. So, as you can see that all three of them fell somewhere. While Susan fell back, she shouted for Taha. All three were no longer at their place of hiding. So, since all three of them were hiding on the base of the chimney and somehow one side of the chimney opened and when it opened, all three of them fell into some other place and now they were no longer there in the chimney. So, Taha heard Susan's shout. Now, as you can see, Taha heard Susan's shout, came running towards the chimney, but nobody was there. Now, since all the three friends had fallen, so Taha could hear only Susan's shout. She ran towards the chimney, but they were no longer there. So, she felt very unusual and started touching the place all over. So, she felt that something is very strange and weird. I cannot find my friends, and I heard Susan's long shout. So, as she came behind, a small shutter opened and she fell into it. So, a small shutter box just opened, as you can see, and even she fell into that. So, it was very dark there. She called for her friends, but no response. So, while she was falling, she also called out to her friends, but there was no reply. She crawled into that dark tunnel. After some time, she saw some light. She kept on crawling. Crawling is moving on your hands and feet. And then finally she found a tunnel. After that, tunnel came to an end. There came some light. So finally, let's read more. So finally she fell down on the white snow. She saw snow-covered trees. So the place where she fell, as you can see, was all covered with snow. It has snow-covered trees. So she gathered the snowflakes in her hand and made a small snowball, which she threw as she noticed three pair of footprints on the snow. So when she saw footprints on the floor, she made a snowball and hit it with that. And then they were off her friends. She started following them. Far away, she saw a large snow-white place. So when she observed, she realized that those were the footprints of her friends, and she started to follow those footprints. And then she reached the snow-white palace. After that, while she was looking at, she was stopped by a white bear. He said, "Taha, where are you going? Don't go that side." So while she was going and looking at the White House Palace or the White Snow Palace, then a white bear stopped him and told that, "Taha, where are you going? Do not go there, to that place." So Taha looked at that wonderful bear. Out of surprise, she asked, "How do you know my name?" So since Taha met him for the first time, she asked him, like, "How do you know my name?" So, the bear caught hold of her hand and signaled her to be quiet. He said, "Come with me. Don't be afraid." So, this uncle, Mr. Bear, told Taha to be quiet and follow her and not be afraid because she is safe there. So, soon they reached a snow house. His wife, Mrs. Bear, welcomed them. So both Taha and Mr. Bear, they reached a snow house where they were welcomed by Mrs. Bear. They took Taha inside and made her sit in a chair. The bear told Taha, "I know your three friends too. They have been taken to Wonderland and they were playing with snowballs when they were caught by the soldiers of the White Witch." So, the bear said that, "I know your three friends as well, and when they came here, they were playing with snowballs, and then the soldiers of the White Witch had captured all three of them." Right after that, she lives in a snow-white palace. They have been taken there. While they were being taken away, they were shouting, "Taha, Taha." Thus, I came to know your name. So, the bear said that while they were playing, then the soldiers of the White Witch captured them. And when they captured them, they took them to the White Snow Palace or the Snow White Palace. And while they were going there, they were shouting, "Taha, Taha." And that is how I came to know about your name, and I knew that you would surely come for them. So, Mrs. Bear brought hot chocolate for Taha. but she didn't even touch it. So now Taha was very scared. So she didn't even touch the hot chocolate that Mrs. Bear gave to her. Mrs. Bear said, "Taha, all who are taken to the palace are turned into snow statues, which is very cruel." So Mrs. Bear told Taha that anybody who reaches that palace, the snow white palace, is turned into white statues or snow statues, and the witch or the lady who is there is very cruel and harsh. So, "But my friends have done no harm to anyone. I want them back," answered Taha. So Taha said that my friends have not harmed anyone and they have always been kind and helpful to everyone. So I want my friends back. This was said by Taha. And then Mr. Bear told Taha, "The white witch is ruling this wonderland. All the snow statues can become alive by the touch of children. With that, the witch will melt." So Mr. Bear told her that all of them have been turned into snow statues, but they will all start melting if any child touches them. And once they touch them, even the witch also starts melting. So Mr. Bear, "Taha can do it." Mrs. Bear said that Taha can also do it. Taha said, "Me?" Mr. Bear, "Yes, you. The white witch sleeps in the moonlight. At that time, you can do it. So when the witch is asleep, you can just go to her palace and touch your friends so that they convert into normal and the snow starts melting. And this is how you will be able to save your friends." After that, Mrs. and Mr. Beard covered Taha in a white sheet. They carried her to the palace when all were sleeping. So Mrs. and Mr. Bear covered Taha with a white sheet so that she is not caught by the soldiers, and they took her to the palace when everybody was sleeping there. So Taha crawled quietly from the back of the guards and entered the hall. So while she was crawling very quietly, she also passed the guards without getting noticed, and she entered the hall. A number of statues stood there, some statues so big, others so small, but all frozen. So when she entered there, she saw many statues there. Some were big, some were small, but they were all frozen with ice. So at the back, her friend statue were also there. She wept and touched Susan, Asmi and Anil. So when she saw her friend statue, she cried and touched all the three statues. Right after that, there was a crackling sound and it brought them to life. So there was a crackling sound, which means that the ice broke and all her friends came back to life. After that, Taha understood the magic of the white witch. They were happy to see Taha. She told them about the magic. They all started touching the statues. So Taha this time understood the magic of the white witch. She and her friends were also happy to see Taha. Then Taha shared this magic with her friends. And after that, all of them started touching all the statues so that everyone can be brought back to life. So there was a loud shout of the white witch. She started melting and her palace. So when all four of them started touching the statues, even she started melting. Why? Because her strength was those statues. And the palace two started melting. All friends ran out. Taha also ran but fell down. She was hurt, so she opened her eyes and found herself on the floor of her room. So they were all running out of the palace, and while running, Taha fell. When she fell, she opened her eyes, and as you see, when she opened her eyes, she saw that she's lying on the floor and she had visited the Wonderland in her dream. So basically, Taha was sleeping and this was a beautiful dream that she saw. And it was her own imaginary creation that she went to a place like that and all the things which happened were all part of her mysterious and fanciful dreaming. So I hope that you understood and enjoyed this particular chapter. And now we are going to attempt a few questions related to this chapter. So first up we have the conceptual based questions. Herein we are going to solve some MCQ questions together. Here one question will have three options. Out of those three options, only one option is correct. So are you going to help me understand and solve these questions? Yes. First up we have, how many friends did Taha have? 4, 3, or 2? So she had 3 friends. They were all, what were they all playing? So they were playing around or running around, touch and run or hide and seek. They were all playing hide and seek. So where were all the friends hiding? At the tip of the chimney, at the base of the chimney, in the middle of the chimney. They were all hiding at the base of the chimney. And then, while falling backward, who shouted for Taha? Asmi, Anil, or Susan? So it was Susan who called out for, or who shouted for Taha. And then, what did Mrs. Bear bring for Taha? Hot chocolate, ice cream, or white sheet? So she brought hot chocolate for Taha first. And then let's see some more questions. Herein we are supposed to fill in these blanks. So dash, dash, and dash all were friends. So Taha, Anil, and Asmi were friends. Soon they reached Snow Dash where Mrs. Bear dashed them. They reached Snow House where Mrs. Bear welcomed them. And then all the snow statues can become alive by the touch of children. Mr. and Mrs. Dash Bear covered Taha in a white sheet. They carried her to the palace when all were sleeping. Taha understood the magic of the White Witch. She has visited the Wonderland in her dream. And this is how we solved all the fill in the blanks. I hope that your answers also matched it. And now we are going to write T for true and F for false. T for true stands for the correct statements and F for false stands for all the incorrect statements. So Taha, Susan, Asmi and Anil all were friends. This is true. Next we have, they were playing football one day. This is false. They were all playing hide and seek. And then, 3 of Taha's friends were hiding at the base of the very large chimney. That's also true. Taha crawled into a black tunnel. That's also true. Mrs. and Mr. Bear welcomed Taha inside the snow house and made her sit on the table. No, they made her sit on the chair. So, this is also false. And now you are going to attempt these descriptive questions in your notebook and you are going to find the answers of these questions from this chapter only. Now let's move ahead. We will now attempt some word building questions. Herein we are going to see that in English we often use two words together. For example, snow white or snow covered, the white snow, the snow-covered trees and the white witch. So, we often use two words together. Now take the correct word to complete these sentences. A dash shutter opened and Taha fell into it. So it was a small shutter. So she crawled into the dash tunnel, into the dark tunnel. I would like to have some hot coffee, please. A dash rich or strong wind was blowing in the morning. A strong wind. Does your dog get dash exercise? Does get regular exercise. And now, here you see some incomplete words, as you can already see. So these are adjectives and nouns. Complete and match them. Please note that the nouns and its describing words takes the same letters. Now, you are going to attempt this exercise wherein the initials of these words are going to be the same and then you will match the nouns with their desirable adjectives. Next up, we have some grammar questions. And now, we'll understand a grammatical concept first. So, we will see that it was Taha's turn. This means the turn of Taha. And Anil kept his hand on Susan's shoulder. So the shoulder was of Susan. So the apostrophe is used to show possession or that something belongs to someone. When we highlight that something belongs to someone, then that shows possession. And we use apostrophe there. Now, punctuate these sentences with an apostrophe to show possession. So, I can hear a kitten's cries. So, who's crying? Kitten. So, we will put a punctuation mark, apostrophe here. So, he stood outside the house of Rahul. So, it is going to be Rahul's house. And then, did you find Nikhil's watch? And this is Maya's book. The sun's rays were warm and bright. This is how we put apostrophe to show possessions of different things. Like the watch of Nikhil, the book of Maya and the rays of the sun. And now we will use capital letters in comma wherever it's necessary. So, we will make the names Taha, Susan, Asmi and Anil as capital. And then we will put comma right between their names. So, Mrs. and Mr. Beer took Taha inside. And then the large snow-white palace was of the white witch. So, this is how we have completed three parts. And now you are going to do the other two parts by yourself. Moving on, we will see that choose the correct words from the brackets and fill in the blanks. So, there was an old factory land. So, there was an old factory land. And then it has or was next to the woods. It was next to the woods. All three friends hid at the base of the chimney. So, the answer is going to be hid. Taha had fallen on the snow. So, Taha had fallen on the snow. They were caught by the soldiers of the white witch. So, they were caught by the soldiers of the white witch. And then, you are going to listen to this particular activity. And as we move on, you are going to see this pronunciation, let's write, and a life skill activity. Soon followed by this one last fun time activities for you. So, I hope that you were able to enjoy this beautiful an interesting chapter of the Wonderland. And also don't forget to tell me that what would you like to have in your Wonderland so that it becomes your own Wonderland. I hope to see you super soon with one more new topic. Till then, take care of yourself and keep revising. I'll see you super soon. Bye-bye.